Hi, I'm Roland Gordon, and thank you for watching our advanced TI-Latte user training video for the OPT3101 evaluation module, also known as OPT3101EVM. In this video, we will go over some of the hidden features that the GUI software for the OPT3101EVM has to offer. If you don't already have TI-Latte downloaded on your PC, you can download it at ti.com/OPT3101EVM. There is also an how to use the OPT3101EVM video available online to help you get started. As you can see, the Evm user interface looks very simple, but in the background, there is a powerful Python-based interface that can be harnessed to do various functions like register read-writes, math calculations, data analysis, and plotting, just to name a few. The main window has to be maximized, as initially it is minimized for greater user experience. The main window has several sections that can be used to perform different actions. The essential section has the current script. This is a syntax-highlighted Python interface editor useful for writing scripts to control the device. The script section on the left lets the user manage the scripts on the profile. You can add, modify, and execute scripts in this window. The log section below shows you the real-time response from the hardware, warnings, errors, and other useful information. The Registers GUI interface can be accessed by clicking Registers View, then Component, then Segment. This is a real-time interface enabling the user to control the device as desired. Every register in the datasheet, which is available on ti.com/OPT3101, is available here and can be modified in real time. A short description of the register is shown when you hover over the register's name. The registers are also searchable in the window below. This is just one way to interact with the device. Another way to interact with the device is to use the command line section, which is available on the bottom right of the main screen. This is a regular Python shell and all Python commands are accepted. In addition, you are even able to control the device's registers here, just as in the register interface. For example, if the TG enable register has to be set to 1, you can do TG enable equal 1. This initiates the I2C register in the device to set the particular register, in this case TG enable, as for what is given in the command line. The log window will show the physical write into the hardware. This is the string that is sent to the COM port to the MSP430 in the OPT3101EVM. The MSP430 will translate this to an actual I2C write. To read a register, you can use a particular format and initiate a read transaction from the device and display the value of the register in the log window. Users can add their own scripts to perform a variety of tasks such as calibrations or their own application prototype. It is standard Python syntax format, so we can have loops, assignments, and mathematical operations. This is an example script for a threshold application. If the phase output recorded by the OPT3101EVM is greater than 1000, the output will be the string far. If the phase output is less than 1000, the output will be the string near. After changes, you can press Ctrl S to save the scripts, then press F5 to execute the scripts. You can see the results of the execution, errors, and warnings in the log window below. The entire GUI interface on the main window is written using scripts that can be found under the default OPT3101EVM demo profile as a part of the TI-Latte installation. The source code can be found here with all the function and API calls. Similar scripts can be written by the user to develop their own applications to display graphics using these scripts. All of the source code that is required to control the hardware is available, which makes the system very transparent, giving the user the ability to harness the interface's full power. To access all the tools and documents that we created to help you prototype easier and faster, visit ti.com/OPT3101. If you need technical support with OPT3101, visit ti.com/support, where you will find a variety of ways to connect with us. Thanks for watching.